With the firing of Willie Randolph and my New York Mets sucking it up, I've decided a good way to stay positive would be to play a classic NES baseball game. But which one?
Alright, I want to pick a baseball game. Yeah, I'll make sure I know how to actually take the picture right. I want to pick a baseball game. Which one to go for? Bad News Baseball. This is by Tecmo, not Bad. Frank.
As much as I love those strikes, I've seen a nice little bunny umpire. I'll have to pass on this one.
Ow! We have regular baseball. If only you can move your fielders in this one. Baseball Simulator 1000. Baseball Stars. Ah! Baseball Stars, as I almost down my bees here. Base Wars, really? Seriously? No. Bases Loaded. Classic. Well, this is Bases Loaded 2. Or is Bases Loaded 1? That's in a box somewhere. Anyway, we're going to go with Bases Loaded. I mean, no, what is it? Baseball Stars?
What?
Quite possibly the worst shooting angle ever. I'm going to pop it in. And hit reset. And hit reset. Pop it out. And blow on it.
Baseball Stars for the NES, here we go! Gives you that feeling of old-time baseball, look at this. The first thing you'll notice is the wide variety of menu selections available. Season Mode, Create a Team, all innovative for the time since Baseball Stars was the first NES sports game to feature a battery backup. The gameplay itself is fantastic. Besides lush colors, solid music, and large animated characters, in the field you can dive for balls, dive in the air, annoy your team by throwing the ball away, and even climb the wall, and sometimes fall to your death in doing so. The teams are fun and feature one filled with monster names, a women's team.
There's no crying in baseball!
And a Hall of Fame type team called the American Dreams. This team features greats such as Sandy Koufax, Babe Ruth, Willie Mays, and, Jax? Baseball Stars feature a 6-team, 125-game season which actually tracks season stats for all players in the league, not just your own. The only downfall to season mode is that you have to autoplay all the computer versus computer games. However, they go by in the blink of an eye. Unlike other baseball games for the system, Baseball Simulator 1000. You can watch a real baseball game in the time it takes to autoplay this. Seriously, this is awful. The Create a Team mode is great. You start by selecting your team type. You choose a team name, the logo, and even can change the names of your players and improve their abilities with cash. You can fire players and hire new ones in a slick prototype of a Create a Player mode. Choose a type of player, rookie, veteran, superstar, and even gender. Yes, boys, this is an equal opportunity game. If you don't have enough cash, you'll have to win games with your creative team to earn more. To illustrate how to earn money, I'll quickly defeat the lovely ladies.
Now, 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 now
Alright, I would have shown you the money you would have gotten by beating the lovely ladies, but I just lost, so... yeah.
Out of the 20 or so baseball games on the NES, Baseball Stars was arguably the best, even surpassing its own sequel. It's all the fun of the baseball experience, without the agita of eating horse-filled hot dogs.
Take me out to the ball game, take me out with the crowd, oh yeah, I'm gonna stop singing 'cause I'm terrible.